Welcome to the Campervan channel, the YouTube channel for all things VW camper. Things don't get much more VW camper than the California, the only campervan Volkswagen have ever made themselves. VW's in-house camper brand arrived on the scene a bit late in the day, to be honest, but it has more than made up for lost time and is now blossoming into an entire California family. You'll find videos on all the different models of California on the channel, so don't forget to check those out. But for now, enjoy the big picture of the Volkswagen California story. If you're new to the campervan scene like me, it's really easy to think that Volkswagen have built campervans from the beginning of time. Not so. They made variants of the Transporter right from the start, combis, minibuses, pickups, and even ambulances. But campervans were never on the drawing board. It took an independent German coach builder, Westfalia, to spot the potential of using all of that space in the back of a Transporter for living accommodation. The story goes that in 1951, an officer in the British or possibly American forces, no one seems to be sure which, was stationed in Germany, bought an early Transporter and took it to Westfalia and said, "Would you mind awfully turning this into something that I can live and sleep in as well as drive?" Westfalia said yeah, and their solution was to come up with camping boxes, a kind of camping kit of parts that you could slide into your combi or window van at the weekend, enjoy a couple of days camping, and then slide it all back out again when you got home and needed your bus or combi for the working week. These camping boxes became official VW special order items, and about 1,000 of them were sold between 1951 and 1958. Not massive sales, but the camping box had established that the Volkswagen Transporter could be used for camping, even if it was on a part-time basis. VW credits Westfalia with showing its first true conversion in 1951, but it was a few years before permanently converted Westfalia campervans could be ordered through your VW dealer. Westfalia's VW campers evolved through the life of the Splitty and became even more popular as converted bay windows. When the third generation of Transporter arrived, the straight-edged, angular, wedge-fronted T3, T25 or Vanagon, call it what you like, Westfalia turned it into a very well-equipped and very successful camper called the Joker. By 1988, VW was keen to increase campervan sales with something a little bit more affordable than the Joker. And when the new, more accessible, slimmed-down T3 camper arrived, it was called, wait for it, the California. See, we got here in the end. So yes, these T3s were the first Californias, influenced and sold by VW, but converted by Westfalia. The layout and key features of these first Calis are still very familiar today. It had a folding two-seat rear bench that flattens to form a bed. A narrow kitchen pressed up against one wall behind the driver, with a fridge, storage cupboards, sink and gas hob all built in. The wide sliding door gave access to the living area, where you could put up a table which stowed away when you were travelling. The T3 Californias had the option of an elevating pop-top roof or a solid glass fibre high top, both creating space for an extra double bed. You could choose one of four engines, but only two colours, pastel white or masala red. It was a mobile holiday home for four people, according to the brochure. Now, VW says there's no official record of how the California name was chosen, but at first it was only applied to this one special model. It was built alongside the Joker for a while, and around this time Westfalia also launched the Atlantic, a very high-spec camper costing 7,000 Deutschmarks more than the 40,000 Deutschmarks you'd pay for a California. I've tried to work out what all that adds up to in modern euros or pounds, but it was so complicated I gave up. The California came along only 3 years before the end of the T3's main production run, but still managed to sell over 22,000 units. In 1990, VW launched the radically different T4 Transporter, and the California version appeared a year later. Inside, the campervan layout was pretty much the same as before, but the big difference with the T4 was that the engine was in the front. Westfalia, and by now scores of other independent converters, no longer had the inconvenience of a blooming great lump of engine stuck in the back. It gave them more room to play with, and they had even more if they opted for the new long wheelbase option, or a T4 with a high or half-height roof. The T4 Cali had other refinements like swivelling driver and passenger seats that could turn 180 degrees and face into the van. Smart though the new Cali T4 was, the cost had crept up to around 50,000 Deutschmarks. So in 1993, they trimmed a few features and a couple of thousand Deutschmarks off the price with a leaner version called the California Coach. But other models went large, the California Tour and the California Club making the most of long wheelbases and high top options. A limited edition of 500 highway models appeared, packed with car-like extras including electric windows and mirrors and central locking. Westfalia threw everything it had at the exclusive, including a long-awaited toilet. There had long been calls for a built-in loo from people who can stomach answering the call of nature in their very expensive campervans. The longer wheelbase finally allowed the space for a separate washroom. The price tag, 60,000 Deutschmarks. I still haven't a clue what that means. In 1996, the T4 had a bit of a facelift. Well, actually it was more of a nose job, but it was more than cosmetic. The T4 got airbags and ABS, and a much stiffer body went down particularly well on campervan conversions. In these T4 times, special editions became an almost annual feature of California production. They would bundle in items that would cost you extra if you added them to a regular California. The light green T4 you've been watching is the Freestyle. Other specials included the Advantage and the Event. In total, around 39,000 T4 Californias were sold, and Volkswagen's relationship with Westfalia had been going swimmingly well. But in 2001, just before the T4 was due to go out of production, Westfalia was taken over by one of VW's biggest rivals, Daimler Chrysler. Awkward, but it did prompt Volkswagen to finally make the decision to build its own Californias in-house on a new Transporter, the T5. The first all-VW California T5s went into production in 2003. They started life on the Transporter production line at Hanover, and then moved to a new VW facility in the city suburbs to complete their campervan conversion. The T5 Calis followed the tried and trusted layout of their earlier namesakes, but featured a whole range of new materials and improvements. Aluminium allowed the pop-top roof to be flatter and lighter, and it was now opened electro-hydraulically at the push of a button. A new source of pop-top envy, if ever there was one. Inside, the furniture was made from thin aluminium plates with a corrugated core and surfaces trimmed with wood effect film. Space-saving sliding doors were everywhere. The standard vehicle was anything but basic. However, customers could buy a Comfortline version. The eye-catching all-white No Limit went on sale. Despite its name, there was a limit, a production run of just 222. The Beach was the less expensive entry model. It was more of a multivan that you could sleep in, as opposed to a full-blown camper. A manually operated pop-top had to be ordered, otherwise you got a standard roof. And we can't wrap up the special editions without mentioning the Black Edition. Only 50 of these sexy beasts were made. If Batman ever needed a campervan, this was the one. Storing the foldaway table had been a challenge for campervan converters for years. The T5 California's ingenious solution was stowing it within the sliding door. A similar solution was found for two folding camping chairs. They slid inside the lower portion of the rear tailgate. Using all available space had become an art form. VW's T5 California had set the bar for quality, innovation, and clever campervanning ideas. When the T6 California came along, it kept all of that, but took it to whole new levels of sophistication and tech. Electronic driving aids, some of them optional, I might add, mean you no longer have to worry about a whole load of things, like running pedestrians over in town if you have city emergency braking. Another system can stop you careering out of control going down steep hills. Warnings will stop you pulling out into the path of vehicles in your blind spot. And you no longer have to use all of that energy dipping and undipping your headlights thanks to automatic main beam control. It seems we're well on the way to a fully specced California not needing a driver at all. Only joking, I think. Recent styling updates have had more than a nod to campervan heritage. Very smart 18-inch disc alloys are reminiscent of the steel wheels on the original T1. Two-tone paint jobs are also a reminder that however high-tech and well-equipped these modern Californias are, they're still the great-great-great-grandchildren of those legendary 1950s VW campers. All the Californias I've mentioned so far have been built on the VW Transporter. But we mustn't forget that VW's in-house converters have worked their magic on other Volkswagen commercial vehicles too. The third generation Caddy was first transformed into a micro motorhome in 2005, and for some reason they called it the Caddy Tramper. The Caddy's fourth incarnation was transformed into the Caddy Beach, borrowing the name from its bigger California brothers, but never officially referred to as a California. Recently, we've heard that the Caddy Beach will live on in the just released fifth generation. All we've got to work on is a set of artists' impressions, but the panoramic skylight roof looks like the wow option for these tiny campers, which VW describe as being ideal for the occasional spontaneous micro-adventure. However, the latest revelation is the Caddy California, the first baby to officially join the California clan. Its big attraction is its optional pull-out kitchenette. With the tailgate open, you just pull out the tiny kitchen unit to the rear. Okay, so technically you're outside the van when you're sizzling your bacon and eggs, but you can still stand full height, and the tailgate does give you some protection if it rains. The bed is also a big upgrade on previous Caddy campers, with the same comfy cup spring technology that you'll get on grown-up Californias. Eventually, you'll also be able to buy a modular tent system to extend your camping space. There's much more detail in my video on the Caddy California. The link is in the description below. So far, there's no guarantee that the new baby will be available in the UK, but Big Daddy certainly is. The Crafter has long been the large van in the VW range, and when an all-new version was unveiled in 2016, Volkswagen experimented with turning it into a big California. The result was a California XXL, a concept for an astoundingly well-equipped campervan, or should that be motorhome, with underfloor heating, a digital projector, masses of storage, an enormous panoramic roof, 6 USB points and an espresso machine. It generated an enormous amount of interest, enough to make VW launch a real-world version in 2019. Volkswagen named their big, cool and contemporary camper the Grand California. There are two versions, the 600 and the 680. The 600 is the short version at 6 metres and sleeps 4. The 680 is longer at 6.8 metres and unexpectedly only sleeps 2. Let's deal with the 600 first. Shorter it may be, but the 600 has the higher camping roof, which allows enough headroom to have a slatted pull-out bed above the cockpit. Up there, there's a skylight with a blind, handy reading lights, USB ports, and a drop-down ladder for access. The bed has a weight limit of about 150 kilograms, so probably more suitable for two children than adults. Volkswagen does describe the 600 as a 2 plus 2. The big news on the Grand Californias is their wet room, a combined shower and toilet. The wet room is only 82 centimeters square, but clever use of space includes a sink that flips down when you want to use it and then flips up out of the way when you want the space for a shower. The main double bed is at the back. You sleep crosswise in the 600, and there's plenty of locker space and generous storage beneath the mattress, which you can access from the double doors at the back. The main differences with the 680 is that the rear bed is longer and you can sleep in line with the vehicle. The kitchen is also slightly bigger, with a bit more cupboard space and work surface than on the 600. And of course, there's no additional bed above the cab. Under the bonnet of both Grand Californias is a 2-litre, 177 brake horsepower turbo diesel engine. An 8-speed automatic gearbox comes as standard, and the 680 model has the extra option of 4-motion four-wheel drive. So there it is, the California name that first appeared on Westfalia's T3 camper conversions is now the brand for an entire family of VW campervans. If you own any of them, tell us what they're like to live with in the comments box below. And if you've enjoyed this overview video, please subscribe to the channel and click on that bell icon. That way, you'll be the first to know when every new video comes off the assembly line. For now, thanks for watching.